Hello everyone, Coach Liz here. It is the week of Thanksgiving holiday. That can be scary for some people, so I'm going to give you some of my top health tips on how to navigate through Thanksgiving or any holiday party, really. But before I get into that, I just want to touch on the healthy habit this week in the life book. Element 17, it talks about exercise, two types of exercise. There is NEAT exercise, which is non-exercise activity thermogenesis, meaning that you're just moving your body more, not putting on your gym shoes and going for a run, but just trying to find ways to be more active. A few suggestions that you could do is walking more. Look for ways to take extra steps. That might be walking farther in the parking lot, parking farther away, taking the elevator instead of the stairs, turning on music while you are cooking or doing housework so that you're moving more. Do things manually, like a hand can opener, drying the dishes, things that will just move your body more. So look for ways to get your neat points by just moving your body more throughout the day instead of sitting so often. And then of course, there's traditional exercise. It's so important that you're moving your body intentionally, I'd say every day, even if it's for 5 minutes. So let's start with some baby steps, some micro habits of health with exercise. So if you aren't currently doing an exercise program like walking regularly or going to the gym or weightlifting, though, that's so good for your body. Why don't we just start with something small? For example, if you want to get stronger, why don't we start with doing one push-up a day? Anyone can do one push-up a day. And if you really cannot do one push-up, stand against the wall and use your body weight for a push-up. And as you get stronger, then you'll be able to do it on the ground. But you'll find that most days, even if your goal is one push-up a day, you're probably going to do more than one. And that's how you're going to build that muscle and that habit of taking time every day to do something active. So think of something, a micro habit of health with exercise that you can start doing every day. Might just be running up and down the stairs 3 times a day or putting on your shoes every day and walking to the end of your driveway. And you'll find that most often you'll probably walk a little bit further. But even if you just make it to the end of your driveway and back, that is building that habit. So exercise is our healthy habit this week. Next, I want to give you some of my top tips for a successful Thanksgiving feast. Now, one thing to remember is Thanksgiving is about the people, the memories. It's not about the food as much as we like to think about that. And in our day and age, that food that we have on Thanksgiving is not rare. You could go any day of the week and get any of that food at a restaurant, at the deli, you could make it. It's not like a rare occasion that you have to eat that food. So if you are working on some healthy habits, I'm going to give you 3 options. And these are my top 3 options. Number one, which is the best option, if you're doing great with your health program and your why is pretty strong as far as why you're getting healthy, you can definitely stick to your program on Thanksgiving. I'm even doing that. My husband's on program right now and we're together doing lean and green for Thanksgiving. So simple. Just make sure that you bring a healthy side dish to go with the meal so that you know that there's going to be at least one vegetable on your program. So that might be a salad, a relish tray, some green beans, something like that to go with the turkey. So that's super simple. You just get your lean and green plate, you eat it, then you go away from the table and you go play a game. You're not by the dessert. Super simple. You're just going to feel so proud of yourself. And you can also do like some sugar-free jello with some whipped cream for dessert if you want kind of a healthy alternative. And then the second option is if you've decided ahead of time that there's some things that you just can't pass up on Thanksgiving. Maybe like you just love your aunt's rolls that she makes and she only makes them for Thanksgiving and you just want some rolls or stuffing or something like that. Then I would say stay on track all day long, just like you were in a normal day. And then for that meal, allow yourself a quarter of your plate for those carbs that you're going to have. So it might be like one little spoonful of mashed potatoes, one little spoonful of stuffing, a piece of a roll. So only choose your very favorite things that you can't live without and just eat everything else and then really savor, like use a baby spoon and just savor those things that you chose. And then after the meal, just jump right back on track. Don't get stuck in that yo-yo mentality of, oh, I'm already out of fat burn. I might as well eat all the pie too. So that's really what we want to work on is avoiding that yo-yo mentality. All right. Option number 3 is you're just going to indulge and stuff yourself like a turkey. And you know what? That's your choice. If that's your choice, own it. Just be okay with that and still stay on track all day long. And then for that one meal, eat what you choose and then jump right back on track. The biggest challenge for you will be to get right back on track after that meal. Don't tell yourself that you've already messed up or you're already at a fat burn, so you might as well eat everything else and start again Monday, because that is like taking 10 steps backwards instead of just one. As if you were to jump right back on track. So that's a big one. And don't skip meals. Don't skip meals to save those calories. Drink lots of water during the day. And one of my favorite things is I love to do something active on Thanksgiving. I love to do a 5K. There's probably a 5K going on in your area that you can go even just walk. But if you can't do a 5K, which is just kind of a fun tradition, go for a walk in the morning. Do something active. Get your exercise in the morning. That'll give you that little bit of extra buffer. So even if you chose to stay on track during that day, maybe you'll have a little bit more lean and green than you normally would. That's okay. You know, if that's your choice, that's fine. But do something active to make up for that little bit of extra calories that you'll be eating. And it's a great way to start the day off, like mentally, to do something active during the day. Also, plan ahead. So I talked about bringing a meal that you can eat. So think ahead of what vegetable you'd like for that meal, and drink lots of water. Make sure that you're just really hydrating yourself that day. Also procrastinate. If you are hosting and you know that there's going to be some unhealthy things that are tempting for you, wait till the last minute to buy it. Don't bring in cookies and desserts and things that are going to be tempting for you ahead of time. Wait until the last minute. And my trick is I buy things that I necessarily don't like. So if it's a dessert, I don't like pumpkin pie. So it's not going to be hard at all to have pumpkin pie on Thanksgiving. So that's kind of the pie that I chose to have. I just chose a couple pies that I really don't care for. And so it's not going to be so tempting for me. So that makes it really easy if you're having things that other people like, but that just maybe aren't your favorite. Like we talked about, just get right back on track and keep going. Even if you weren't 100% for that one meal, you know what? That's okay. A lot of times just thinking about what you'll do different next time or how you can plan ahead better next time, but don't beat yourself up over it. Just own it. Just say, you know, it is what it is. And maybe you did great and celebrate, feel awesome. But the biggest thing is just keep going. So those are my big tips for Thanksgiving. If you need some healthy recipes, we have tons of healthy swaps. So your favorite things that you love for Thanksgiving, there's healthy options too. So reach out. I can hook you up with my favorite Thanksgiving recipes to help you stay on track for this holiday. But biggest thing of all is be grateful. Look for ways that you can enjoy the journey, that you can really enjoy the people you're with and make new memories. It's all about the people, the memories, not about the food. Remember that and have a great week.